Tutorial 2, having looked at importing sources in Tutorial 1, will now focus on another key component of building a database, setting up your classifications, also known in NVivo as attributes and sometimes referred to as the casebook. The purpose of attributes is to link case nodes that we created when we imported our documents in Tutorial 1 with external forces which might influence the attitudes and beliefs, the intangibles that's contained within those cases, which is the data that's actually going to get coded to nodes. So if I open up Site 1, Pupil 1, our first transcript, it contains all of the sources for that particular person. Any audio, textual files, images, field notes or observations, or anything around that case. So the unit of analysis in this instance is a person, and the case contains all of their data. But that's only half the story. It's the integration between this soft data, the attitudes and beliefs, that connect it to the external data, which we're going to call classifications. These will be demographics at its simplest, or indeed integrating it with a quantitative survey or data from the likes of SPSS, which we can also do. We can import data from SPSS, but we'll do that in a separate tutorial. For now, we're going to manually set up the attributes and link them to the cases. Setting up an attribute requires clicking on the Classifications tab, selecting the Attributes folder, right-click, New Attribute. We're going to set up an attribute called Gender. And we're going to give it some values. Male and female. That's step one of a two-step process. The attribute now exists, but what we haven't done is told each of our cases whether they're a man or a woman. We do that on a case-by-case basis. If I go into the properties for site one, pupil one, and I click on the attribute values tab, I can now see the gender attribute that I've set up, only it's unassigned. I'm now going to assign a value against that attribute. And I do that for each of my cases. And then I have full integration between my quantitative and my qualitative data. And I can use these case nodes in the background to drive queries later on, which will find and code data or split down data that's already coded, perhaps by gender, so that I can do a comparative analysis against attitudes and beliefs by gender, if that's what I'm trying to track in my study.